Have you ever experienced a large change in your life that forced you to learn new ways of doing things? Maybe it was adjusting to a new online school, or moving to a new city, or simply just taking on new responsibilities. Change is a natural part of life, and a common characteristic of successful individuals is the ability to adapt or adjust to the environment around them. Other living things, like this chameleon, become successful by adapting to their environment as well. In nature, successful individuals are those who survive and pass on their genes to the next generation. In today's lesson, we'll be exploring this topic as we explain the process of natural selection, describe how the environment affects this process, and evaluate how genetic diversity relates to the adaptability of different species. In our last unit, we learned about how DNA is organized into genes that code for specific traits in living things. When these traits are passed on via the process of meiosis, the result is offspring with a unique combination of traits from both parents. Additionally, mutations during this process create the possibility of brand new traits. All of these factors together result in a wealth of genetic diversity, or a large amount of different genes in living things. The question then becomes, what are all these traits for? Is genetic diversity completely random, or does it serve some kind of purpose? To get to the bottom of this, we need to understand a little bit more about natural selection. Natural selection is the process by which organisms better adapted to their environment tend to survive and reproduce. Unsurprisingly, living organisms are highly motivated to eat when they're hungry and to avoid being eaten themselves. To accomplish these things and successfully reproduce, species must develop adaptations to survive. An adaptation is the means by which organisms adjust or become better suited to their environment. For example, this giraffe's long neck allows it to reach food it wouldn't have access to otherwise. You can think of adaptation as the development of traits that help a species survive. Another example is the great horned owl, which has excellent night vision and specialized feathers designed for silent flight. These adaptations allow the owl to catch and eat more prey, increasing its chances of survival and consequently reproduction. Beneficial adaptations are then passed on to offspring, increasing their chances of survival as well. This ability to survive and reproduce is known as an individual's fitness. At this point, you might be thinking to yourself, okay, so owls are adapted to hunting at night, but an owl is an owl, right? Night vision, silent flight, deadly talons. How does nature select between different owls? Well, owls, like many other animals, have very complex DNA. This includes thousands of genes involving many small variations that can differ from owl to owl. These can make a huge difference when they're all added together. Excellent night vision is a great trait, but what about even better night vision? If you were an owl, would you rather have kind of sharp talons or really sharp talons? Silent flight is great too, but what about speed or strength? All of these adaptations are advantages that really add up to increase an individual owl's fitness. Owls are all unique, and no matter how similar two individuals might seem, one will have a better combination of traits and a higher fitness than the other. Natural selection says that nature tends to select for the more fit individual to pass on its traits. It's also important to keep in mind that an individual's environment matters just as much as its traits. For example, a great white shark is incredibly fit to survive in the ocean, but it wouldn't last very long in a desert. And traits that are beneficial for climbing won't help much in a flat area. Additionally, the features of environments change over time, influencing which traits increase fitness. So as environments change, species are forced to adapt as well. One famous example of this is the peppered moth. As a result of the Industrial Revolution in England during the late 1800s, much of the English countryside was enveloped in black smoke. This pollution changed the color of the trees from a light, almost white color to black instead. As this continued, scientists in the area began to notice something strange. The population of peppered moths that caught these trees home began to change color as well. Before the Industrial Revolution, both light and dark color variations existed in the peppered moth, but the light variation was much more common than the dark variation. Can you guess why? Write down your thoughts in the guided notes. Moths with light-colored genes were able to blend into the trees better to avoid being eaten. In other words, they had a higher fitness, which increased their chances of surviving and reproducing. However, as a result of how pollution changed their environment, all of a sudden, dark-colored moths were better at blending into the trees. Now they were the group with a higher fitness. Over time, this allowed more of these dark-colored moths to survive and reproduce. In just 10 years, the moth population completely flipped from being mostly light-colored to mostly dark-colored. This brings us back to genetic diversity. Before the Industrial Revolution, the light-color variation was clearly better suited for the environment than the dark-color variation. However, if the dark-color variation had never existed, the entire population of moths would have been unable to blend into the trees when the environment changed. In this way, the different variations of traits are like an insurance for a species. If the landscape or weather changes, or a new species migrates into an area and disrupts the environment, different traits are like backup plans species can use to maintain their fitness in changing conditions. The more genetic variation there is in a species, the more adaptable that species is overall. So the next time you find yourself observing nature, think about why the living things that you see have the traits that they do. What advantage do those traits provide? Additionally, what differences exist between the members of the same species, and how does that affect the species overall? And with that, we have concluded our lesson on natural selection. We've learned that natural selection is the process by which individuals with higher fitness survive and reproduce. Species survive by adapting or adjusting to their environment, and these adaptations are passed on to offspring. Additionally, genetic diversity or a wider variety of traits help species adapt more quickly if their environment changes over time. In our next lesson, we'll be diving into taxonomy, which is the science of categorizing living things. Until then, fellow biologists, I'm Tony, and remember, life is full of wonders, so keep on learning and don't ever stop wondering.